Do you want to receive automatic notification from Home Assistant and maybe even start autoplay when your favorite YouTube creator releases its own video? Well, if you're interested into YouTube integration for Home Assistant, and yes, this is custom integration, and no, it's not even available in HACS, then this video is for you. We'll start in a couple of seconds. Last week, Mark Watt had a stream, and on its stream there was one question that popped up. Is it possible to receive notification when YouTuber or content creator either releases video or starts streaming? And yes, there is a way to do it, but unfortunately this is not internal Home Assistant integration, and it's also not available, well at least not currently, in the HACS. So today we are going to be working with the YouTube integration for Home Assistant. Custom component. In today's video, I will show you how to integrate or install this custom component inside your Home Assistant, and later on we will see what are possibilities with this integration. And really there are a lot. If we, for example, look at my current setting, where I'm pulling data from my YouTube channel, you can see that there are a lot of attributes that we can use and play with. For example, some of the ideas. We have URL, and this is the URL to the latest video. Next, we have Content ID. If you want to play with it, you can play with it. Then we have Published, which is date and time when the video itself was published. Stars, of course, means thumbs up. Views shows you the total views for that video. Is it a stream? When did the stream start? Is it live? Is the channel live? And of course, channel image. So by combining or using some of the attributes, what are some of the things that we can do? And we will do later in the video. First of all, we may get notified if there is a new video, which is very easy to do automation. Then of course, for some of the YouTube content creators that usually forget to schedule a stream, you yourself can put a watch on the channel and get notified if something is streamed and if it has started. That way, you will get notified when our famous Matt Work starts streaming. Let's start installing this custom component. There are two ways to install this component inside your Home Assistant. So let's look at the simplest one. Go to repository, right-click on YouTube and copy link address. The other option, which I will not be showing you here, is to download the code and copy code by hand. When you copy it, you need to copy all those files inside custom components, subfolder YouTube, and those three files here are from this component. After you install those three files here, inside HACS, integrations, you will see this integration edit here. The other option for those that copied the URL previously, press on three dots here, custom repositories, copy repository URL, this is the HTTPS, GitHub, custom components, YouTube, select category, integration, and press add. I cannot edit myself because it's already installed on my system. So no matter of what type of installation you choose, either direct copy of files inside custom components YouTube folder or via adding the URL inside HACS, next step of course is to restart your Home Assistant. Go to developer tools, check your configuration and restart your system. Next step is also manual configuration of this component or integration. In our sensors file, so either under sensors in configuration YAML file, or in your sensors YAML file, or in sensors folder, which I have in my system, we have to add two lines. One is called platform YouTube, which tells system that we want to use YouTube integration for this, and the next one is channel ID. Let me copy this. Let's go to Visual Studio Code, and here I have my sensors folder. So we can create couple of sensors. In my case, each of the sensors is in the independent file, so I will create one new file. Plus YouTube bearded thinker.yaml, and I will paste this code here. Let me just give myself a reminder or comment here, YouTube integration for bearded thinker. The question is, how do you get this channel ID? Retrieving channel ID is not as easy as it used to be. Previously, most of the channels had channel information as a string here. I myself have TubeBuddy installed on my system, and for each channel I can see channel ID here. Let me copy this one, as this is my channel ID and we will be using it later on in Home Assistant. If, for example, I would search for Mark Watt Tech and press on his channel, yes, I still do not see his channel ID here, but I can retrieve it via TubeBuddy here. Next option for you to retrieve the channel ID is, for example, to go to any of the videos from YouTube Creator, then go back to his channel. And you now will see the channel ID for that specific content creator. In this case, Mark Watt Tech. Let me go back to Home Assistant and create integration for my channel. In the file I've created, I will paste here the channel ID for my channel and press save. Let's create one additional file and let's, for example, add here Slacker Labs or Jeff. I will copy everything from this folder, paste it here, rename it or give it name Jeff, and in order to retrieve channel ID, I will type here Slacker Labs, click on the channel. Yes, I can copy channel ID here, but I will press on the latest video, press on Slacker Labs, and copy channel ID here from the top. Paste it here and save. Now we have created two platform integrations. One is for one channel, which is my channel, and the other one is for the channel from Jeff. Mind you, I still haven't tested if this works with multiple YouTube channels, so this will be a fun test. Let's go to Developer Tools, check configuration, and restart Home Assistant. While system is rebooting, I really would like to thank everybody who has become YouTube channel member and is supporting me on the YouTube channel. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. But also, I would like to thank everybody who watched, liked, or subscribed to my channel. If you too want to support the channel, you can do so by clicking the join button down below. And of course, if you did like this video or any previous video I did, don't forget to subscribe. It not just means a lot to me, but it really helps with the YouTube channel. Thank you all once again. After your system has restarted, you should now have new sensor, or in my case, two new sensors. Mind you, the update of the sensor can take some time, so if you don't see it at first, wait. If nothing else, then reboot your system once again. Yeah, I know. Let's search for sensor, bearded tinker, and here we have icon. This is the icon or image that's been pulled off internet, and it shows the thumbnail of the latest video. Let's also check if we have Slacker Labs. Yes, we have Slacker Labs. Information for Slacker Labs is URL, content ID, which some devices when you stream may need, so you have content ID, date when the video was published, how many stars, and as I mentioned, stars are all thumbs up, but also includes thumbs down. So for example, this can be 40 thumbs up or 20 thumbs up and 20 thumbs down. Views, is this a stream? When did the stream start? Is this alive? Is the channel live? Channel image, entity picture, icon, and of course, friendly name. For Bearded Thinker, almost everything is the same, but quite opposite because my last video was actually streamed. So we have stream true, stream start. This is the time when the stream started. Is it live? Is the channel live? Channel image, entity picture, icon, friendly name. So now that you have everything set up in your Home Assistant, the question is what you can do with it. There are a couple of things, but bear in mind. If you are tracking change of the state, unfortunately all the stars and views will also count as a change of state. So for example, if you want to track if there is a new video or not, you can either track the URL changed, publish time changed, or something similar. Let's go to Settings, Automations, Create New Automation, Empty Automation, and let's call it Bearded Released New Video. Trigger will be state of the sensor Bearded Thinker 2, and as we said, we want to track optional thing, and in our case, this will be URL. We are using trigger for the state, but we are not using it on entity, instead we are using it on attribute. As I mentioned, this will have no impact if we receive either thumb up or thumb down for that video. We can now create action, and this action can be call service, notify bearded bot, title can be new video from BT, and message body can be anything. Don't forget to watch my new video and give it a like. Or of course you can use template sensor here and use it to send you the URL so you can from notification click on URL and watch the video. In my main setup I have created this play latest from Bearded Thinker, and if I press run it will start streaming this URL on my Google Nest device, Google Display device. So that's also one possibility to do. What if we, for example, want to receive notification when video is live, and that can be useful for streams. Let's create new automation. By the way, I didn't try this automation, but it should work. Bearded is streaming. Once again, we will be using state as trigger, Bearded Thinker 2, and for the attribute, we will be using live. As for the trigger state, for this live attribute, we can use toFill and say true. That way, if the video itself is now live, and I think that this works for streams, it should be triggered. Just to be on the safe side that we don't get any false positives, we can say that it needs to be in the live state for at least 1 minute. There is also one additional attribute, and I'm not sure what is the difference between live and channel is live. According to the documentation, live means if the video is live now. Channel is live means that currently the channel has some live activity. And I presume that if there is currently a new live activity, then this URL should take you there. But as I said, I haven't tested that case yet. And it's very complicated to test without starting a stream. And for the actions, once again, in this simple example, I'll be calling a service, notify bot, title will be Bearded is streaming. Looks like Bearded started to stream. And now, as we said, there is a trigger for the entity Bearded Thinker, which is the sensor, YouTube sensor, for the attribute live, where we are tracking or we are triggering this if it changes from false to true or from anything to true, and is in that state for at least 1 minute. And if condition is met or trigger is met, then we call service and send notification that Bearded is streaming, and looks like Bearded started to stream. Of course, once again, you can use the value template here and include the URL. And this is it. As you can see, it is very easy to add this integration to Home Assistant or this custom component, either by using HACS or by manually installing it in the custom components folder. And if you've done everything correctly, you should now have in your system sensors that track your favorite YouTubers or content creators. And as there are a lot of attributes, you are left with a lot of options on how to automate the boring stuff. Hope you did enjoy this video, and if you did enjoy this video, don't forget to give me a like. If you still haven't subscribed, please subscribe and hit the bell button so you get notified on the future videos and updates. If you have any great idea on how to embed this YouTube integration and create some automations, I would really like to hear what are your ideas on this. So feel free to leave a comment down in the comment section below, but also you can go to Discord server and leave a comment there. And I'll be seeing you next time. Until then, bye bye and have fun.